I'm reading from Paul's letter to the Romans. Your love must be sincere. Hate what is evil and cling to what is good. Love one another with the affection of sisters and brothers. Anticipate each other in showing respect. Do not grow slack, but be fervent in spirit. The one you serve is Christ. Rejoice in hope. Be patient. Persevere in prayer. Look on the needs of others as your own. Be generous in offering hospitality. Bless your persecutors. Bless and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice, and weep with those who weep. Have the same attitude toward everybody. Put away ambitious thoughts and associate with those who are lonely. Do not repay evil with evil. See that your conduct is honorable in the eyes of all people. Live peacefully with everyone. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
so they can see this glory of mine, which is your gift to me, because of the love you had for me before the world began. The world has not known you, but I have known you, and these people know that you sent me. To them I have revealed your name, and I will continue to reveal it, so that the love you have for me may live in them, just as I may live in them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I welcome everybody today to this special funeral liturgy for Sister Romaine, and I extend the sympathy of all the Franciscan community to you, Sister Romaine's family, to Sister Rita, to her classmates, to the Franciscan associates, and to the many friends who have come here to celebrate today, and to the nursing staff and pastoral care staff of Caritas. We extend our sympathy and gratitude for your faithful care of Sister Romaine. During these past days and weeks, we've been remembering much about Sister Romaine's life. The significant ministry, the responsibilities she had, her great love of family and community, her deep involvement with the Franciscan Associates, and her sense of fun and adventure. Who knew, for example, that she used to play horseshoes, or that she rode a camel during the trip to the Holy Land? Sister Romaine spent many years as an educator. She was a skilled teacher, and then she became principal. One of the sisters who had Romaine as a principal said of her, "She ran in good shape." Another said of her, "She set high standards for herself, and she wanted others to do the same." Setting high standards. I thought of the letter to the Romans that Sister Romaine herself chose some years ago for her funeral mass. Do not grow slack, but be fervent in spirit. Live peaceably with everyone. Bless your persecutors. Bless and do not curse them. Be generous and offer hospitality. Do not repay evil with evil. The whole reading is a long list that sounds like a litany describing a follower of Jesus. It could well be a litany that Sister Romaine prayed often, that I might be fervent in spirit, help me, Lord, for the gifts of generosity and living peaceably with everyone I pray for God. Help me never to repay evil with evil, Lord. I can imagine Sister Romaine reflecting on these words over the years, mulling them over until they became part of her soul. She recognized that what St. Paul describes were high standards to which she was called as a follower of Jesus. Sister Romaine knew, as we do, that the profoundest of faiths gets lived out in the ordinary everyday of our lives. The best and noblest prayers we pray have to be fleshed out, made incarnate in self-giving and generosity. The expectations Jesus has for his followers are great. Sometimes we do well with God's grace, but challenges arise. For Sister Romaine, maybe it was navigating the snowy roads during her traveling years as a recruiter for Briarcliff. Or maybe it was the challenge she had when, along with other sister principals in the Chicago area, she was receiving and helping prepare many a young sister who came to her school to teach, a sister who had had little, if any, teacher training, and I was going to stand in front of a group of 50 first graders or eighth graders. Sister Romaine wanted them to do well. Just recently, the challenge certainly was severe physical pain. Always there was God's grace to continue on the journey even when it was difficult. In every age, there are those who struggle with Jesus' expectations and ask, why? Why bless mothers and mothers? Why, in this sometimes cruel world, should I show respect to everybody? The answer, I think, is in today's gospel. Jesus, who had been praying, looks us lovingly, squarely in the eyes, and says, I want you to be with me. I want you to share this glory that is mine. The love that the Father has for me is our gift to you. Those words are power. They lure Sister Romaine, and they lure us to follow in Jesus' way. I think Sister Romaine gave us a gift in today's scripture readings. Many years ago, a theology teacher stressed with us, her very young students, that when the Bible is proclaimed during liturgy, as it was today, Christ is present among us in that word. Her point was, listen, be attentive. Today, in the scripture that was proclaimed in our midst, Christ has been present among us, luring us with that same invitation to follow in his footsteps, and we hear as well his promise to be with us. Thank you, Sister Romaine.
Confidence we present our prayers to our merciful God.
Our response will be, Lord, be our life and resurrection. We pray for Sister Romaine. May she enjoy the fullness of life that our God has promised. We pray.
Lord, be our life and resurrection.
For Sister Romaine's relatives who have preceded her in death, her parents, Oscar and Mary Bodyford Pickard, her sisters, Hazel and Ruth, her brothers, Clyde and his wives, Edith and Elsie, Milton and his wives, Faith and Ruth Marie, Joseph, Lyle, and his wife, Elaine, and Deacon, Glenn Pickard. Her sisters, Helen and her husband, Charles Devorah, and Ruth and her husband, Marvin Jacobs, and all her deceased relatives. May Sister Romaine be reunited with them in heaven this day, we pray.
Lord, be our life and resurrection.
For Sister Romaine's living relatives, her sisters-in-law, Helen and Mary Pickard, nieces and nephews, and her Franciscan sisters, with whom she shared over 73 years of her life. May God's peace and comfort be theirs, we pray.
Lord, be our life and resurrection.
For all who ministered to Sister Romaine by their loving care during her recent illness and death, we pray.
Lord, be our life and resurrection.
We pray for new life in ourselves, in the people we love, in the world around us, that God's promise of peace may fill us with hope and healing in our grief, we pray.
Lord, be our life and resurrection.
Gracious God, we ask that you bless us the Romaine and all those who have gone before us with the peace and joy you have promised. We offer this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection is gone, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for us in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Filled with the Holy Spirit,
may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May you make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, your spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Francis and St. Clair, St. Romain, and with all the saints, on his constant intercession in your presence, we rely for his faithful help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Pope Francis, Michael, our bishop, the bishops, the clergy, the religious, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of our family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Sister Romaine, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in the death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. But from the earth, he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our holy body after the pattern of his own glorious body. You are departed, brothers and sisters, too. To all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind attention to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you are God as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, for whom you bestow the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Share, so Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
thank you. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant, Sister Romaine, for whom we have celebrated this sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace, through Christ our Lord. Christ.